Hey everyone, Scary Mountain Wizard here.
I'm going to today show you a really fun way that I like to do something called, or what I've been calling, analog vaporwave. And essentially, it's creating vaporwave without using a VST or computer or a laptop or even without necessarily using like a desktop, like one of those desktop units. Anyway, doesn't matter. So anyway, so the idea here is to like understand, you know, what makes something like a slushwave or a vaporwave track is a lot of times it's the sound of, you know, slowed down, pitched down kind of thing. And there's a big thing nowadays going towards the idea of sample-free vaporwave and sample-free slushwave, which is fine. There's nothing wrong with that. And there's nothing wrong with sampled slushwave and vaporwave either. But for today, just for an example, I'm not necessarily using this for a track, but I'm going to use it as an example just to kind of show if you have, even if you can, you know, even if you can, like, record, you know, your own kind of music onto a cassette and then play this through a cassette deck, you know, this gives you the exact same idea. So anyway, so what we have here is we have a Kenny G cassette loaded into a MothHunterMods tape deck that has specifically a speed control. And so what we're going to do is we're going to show you how with this and a series of pedals, how you can achieve a very slushwave, vaporwave kind of sound. So first what we're going to do is we're going to play, just to give you an example of what we're working with, we're going to play the sample at normal speed, and I'll show you exactly, it's the beginning of a track that I'm going to be sampling. So we're going to play it at normal speed, just to kind of give you an idea of what the track sounds like, and then we'll rewind it and go ahead and do it again. That's the opening sample we're going to use. You know, we can obviously use this to really pitch down the sound. So we're going to go ahead and rewind that. We're going to go ahead then and play it again, and this time we're going to capture the loop in the Ditto and run it as a sample. I made a successful loop of that opening jazzy little part. And so now we have to figure out, you know, what are the things that make, like, so let's say a slushwave track slushwave. It's a lot about that ethereal kind of sound. It's about that dreaminess and that kind of thing. That very hypnagogic, right? That's the word that describes all these sounds. So when I think that, I think something like the slow, specifically the dream setting on the slow. If you turn the mix up just a little past its neutral point, it'll cut the attack on any signal you're flowing into it, and it should actually give you this very nice ethereal sound. I have the decay kind of backed off a little bit because we're going to feed it into some other reverbs and stuff. So but let's go ahead and engage it, see what we do. Already there, we've got a real nice sound. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna increase the depth a little bit, which is gonna give us a little bit of modulation. This gives us a little bit of a tape warble, which is real nice. we're going to go ahead and engage the Polar Bear Effects Drowner for a little bit of reverb and shimmer. Now from this point, this is like your bed track. This is, you know, what you could use as like a bed music. This could be used, you could record on the top of it. You could keep this running. This could be a whole track in and of itself. Yeah, that's just a quick way that you can easily do some very vaporwavy type sounds with analog setup, with definitely with a you know, with tape and some pedals, and go out there and kind of experiment with it, see what you come up with. All right, man, thank you.